Hi, good evening, everybody. Welcome to Network75 question and answer session. It's the first one of two this week. So I'm joined today by five Network75 students and former students. So first thing, we'll kick off by introducing themselves. So Samiha, do you want to introduce yourself, please?
Hi, my name is Samiha Hassan, and I am in my first year of Network75, and I work with the company Arcadis, and it's pretty good, and I'm enjoying myself so far, so good.
Brilliant. Thanks, Samiha. Alice?
I am now a senior strategic planner in Network Rail, and I graduated from Network75 2 years ago.
My name's Aisha, so I'm currently like a third year in Network75. So I'm studying business and management, and I'm working with my host company, Momisha Building Society. And I've worked in a couple of different departments. I've worked in mortgages and savings 6 months respectively. And for the past 2 years now, I've been working in their change and improvement department. So I've been able to work on some really cool, exciting projects to help deliver the society's goals on being a digital business.
Fantastic. And certainly not last, but certainly not least, Jade.
Hi, I'm Jade. I'm a marketing trainee, so I'm in my third year studying marketing management. And I work at Saffron Seats GB, which we make business and first class seats for airlines. So I do answer this question. It comes up a lot, especially at the open days. But I think for me, I have found it manageable, and I think that's just the best way to describe it, because it is demanding. You've got a degree and a job, but I think it makes it easier because you're linking it to your degree. So because the placement is in marketing for me, is easier to link. I think really, if you were doing a degree anyway, you would have some form of part-time job, maybe at a local supermarket or something, for example. And I think they're not as, you know, aware then of the work you're doing and the job you're in. They're going to be fully invested in making sure you succeed, and they allow me time to do work, you know, if needed. So I think it can be a challenge, but is completely manageable, and you work with the uni and the company to make sure it's right for you.
I think one of the great things about improving the work-life balance is that Network75 offers us 6 days of study leave, which is really helpful. So, and also your part-time, so your modules are kind of distributed across the 5 years, so it's not like a full-time student where you're doing the 8 modules in 1 year. It's usually separated by like 4 modules per year probably, but then your final year is probably going to be a little bit different with your dissertation and stuff. But I found the 6 study days to be really helpful, and again, like Jade said, the company that you work with really want you to succeed as well. So they offer you time to work on your assignments as well. So it's just like, it's a good support network to be able to manage that kind of student life and then work life as well.
Right, we've got two ends of the spectrum now. We've got the last two members of the panel. We've got somebody who's just started and a graduate as well. So if we start with Samiha, who's just started the programme. So.
For me, at first, it was quite difficult to wrap my head around because uni was a new thing and work. It only took about 2 weeks to a month, but I did eventually understand things and stuff started to click. So it was really great. It's true. Your company really does want you to do well, and they encourage you. Like, if you need to take study leave, go for it. But I'm managing, thankfully, okay now. I mean, I've come this far, so so good.
Brilliant, well done. And Alice finally as a graduate?
Yeah, I think it is, like, don't get me wrong, it is hard, but like, it's totally worth it. Like, when you look at the end and you've got a good job and you don't have any debt, it's amazing. But yeah, it is, I'm not going to lie to you, it is like, you do have to have good management, good time management. I'm quite a busy person anyway. I was also like coaching trampolining when I was doing my degree and working for Network Rail. But that's just me. I've always been a busy person. So if you've got quite a busy lifestyle and you always like juggling things, I think Network75 is for you. But yeah, no, it's really good, and it is definitely manageable.
One of the great things about working with a company is that I've gotten like a really awesome opportunity with my current department being Change to work on robotics and AI. And you would think, like, you'd look at my degree on paper and you think, how do those two link? So for me, I feel like the work aspect of Network 75 has really enriched my degree and like given me new skills that and like a whole new industry that I normally wouldn't have thought that I'd have access to. So that's something that I've definitely enjoyed, is like you never know the type of opportunity you're going to get. So I would say just try loads of different things. If you are on the Network 75 scheme, go to do the different department rotations. And now I finally found something that I really enjoy, which is Change and project management, and also working towards becoming a robotics developer, which is really cool.
Oh, brilliant. Thanks. Jade?
Yeah, so similar to Aisha, I think it does open a lot more opportunities. So when I joined, I even had the opportunity to travel. So we went to Hamburg in Germany for a seat show, and I got to meet, you know, just people from all over the world, and it was really, really good. And I'm supposed to have the opportunity again, but I mean, that was just amazing for me to be able to go there in my first year and work with people in all different backgrounds. And I think they have made it enjoyable for me as well. They teach me things, you know, that I wouldn't learn in university then. It's just the experience that they have, and it's built my confidence massively. I think to link it with uni, they have just made it so much more easier for me. Instead of graduating and going straight into the job, I think for me, I'm a huge worrier, so that would just stress me. So they have really helped in bridging that gap then.
Samia?
With me, I really enjoy it. Honestly, it was just a new thing. I was going into this game blind because I didn't know what to expect. And I'm a financial administrator, still learning what to do. But from when I started, I've learned quite a lot. And I've always been interested in accounting. So actually creating, say, for example, invoices, it's like you said, something you wouldn't usually learn, like the software that they use. I'm learning, say, Sage in uni and a different software in work. It's just like expanding what I know, and I really enjoy it. It's great.
Well, brilliant. And Alice?
I think like having that experience in work and being able to relate it to your studies is just invaluable. Like, I don't think I would have done as well in uni as I did if I didn't have that experience to kind of fall back on or help me understand. And also, because I had I started doing business management, and then I ended up specializing in logistics and supply chain. And it just gave me, because all the modules are different, it just gave me the opportunity in work to say, look, I'm doing this module, can I sit with this team for a bit and like understand what they do and how it can relate to my university degree and the modules that I'm studying. So yeah, it was really good. It means I got to try like quite a few different teams. I was always based in one team, and then I got to try like different ones depending on the modules I was doing. So I ended up doing a placement for the Champions League final, and I helped project manage that because I was doing some project management. So yeah, it worked really well. But yeah, I don't think I would have done as well in uni if I didn't have that experience to fall back on.
The pressure's on now. What did you get?
I got a first.
Oh, brilliant. I knew you had this. I'm impressed with that because I'm a former logistics manager. So I'm a supply chain logistics nerd as well. So yeah, I know where you're coming from there.
Mine wasn't quite as exotic as Jade's going to Hamburg, but you know, it's given me the opportunity to travel over the UK to like our HQ and like Milton Keynes, for example, look at their logistics and supply chain function. So yeah, not quite Hamburg, but still interesting.
I think volunteering, and well, I did Welsh back in school. So for one of my projects, you have to volunteer, and it could be in like a local place or somewhere near you. And I think that really helps you talk about something in interviews, when you have interviews, because my interviews were video interviews. I've never had interviews before. So I was glad that I had that to talk about, because they do say like what interests you. And I really enjoy the fact that it's work and uni. And I do think volunteering helps a lot, because it helps you build your skills with your planning, because planning sessions, because I volunteered in a boxing centre for like children, so I'd plan like activities for them. But I really think that volunteering is a key to talk about. It's really great and do.
Jude?
I think for getting a place then with the uni at first, would I think it was just like you said, really like the volunteering side. So I applied for a Channel 4 pop-up event, free event to attend in Swansea, and that was a full day of marketing, so that linked to, you know, my degree as well, or what I was going to go for. And yeah, it was a maths tutor, not really linked to marketing management, but just other things that kind of link, not just my grades then. And I think also, you know, going into getting the place at a company, which I think is more difficult, we had to create a poster and describe, you know, why we chose these elements. And I made a focus on like colour and psychology. So I think try and link it to what you're going to do for them and what you're going to be learning in uni, like show that, you know, you're motivated and how you're going to link everything, you know, together to work and learn.
That's a really interesting point, actually, Jade brings up there. The double interview. So it's going through the Network 75 interview and then thinking about how you present yourself to the company as well. So good point, Jade. Alicia?
Yeah, so in addition to all that, I think you also need to kind of practice doing interviews. And one thing that I did was use this website called Barclays Life Skills, which was really great because it provides you about like information with loads of different like interview types, whether it's a group interview, panel interview. And I find that really helped with the business interviews because some of them might have like assessment centers or video interviews, and you can kind of practice what types of questions that they ask and also get to know yourself a little bit better as well. Like you need to know like who you are, like what your ambitions are, what your goals are, what you want to achieve, so that you can really like back yourself. And I think it's important to consider that job interviews as a real chance to like advertise yourself and be proud of the achievements that you've done so far, and also show your enthusiasm and willing to learn. And I think by getting those interview skills down, that can really help you feel a bit more confident when you're taking on the uni interview and the business interview.
Alice, anything you'd like to add to that?
I think it's about enthusiasm and showing that you'll definitely be capable of, like, well, for the Network 75 interview, definitely be capable of balancing work and uni. And yeah, I also agree with what the girl said about volunteering. I definitely think I did a lot of volunteering and had like part-time jobs. I think that just showed my work ethic and showing that I was really willing to do it. So yeah, if you could do anything, just anything outside of school, it definitely helps.
We have like 3 days where you're working with your host company, and then you usually have 2 days at uni. So for me, like in my first year, like my uni days were like Monday, Tuesday, and now my third year, it's like Monday, Friday. So I feel like that helps with the work-life balance as well, because you can have 2 days which you can dedicate to uni and then 3 days which you can dedicate to work. So I really like to split that, so like my head's in work when like for those 3 days, and then when it's uni I only focus on uni. So that's what's helped me.
Do you find you get much crossover in sort of assignments with between the work, you show your work and the university work as well?
Especially with like my project management module that I've done recently, like similar to Alice, like when you can like learn that theory and then literally the next day in work, like you'll be hearing like that being implemented and delivered, and you're like, it just really cements it for me, the fact that like I'm able to learn it in uni and then literally like the next day or in the next couple of weeks I'm already applying it. And I think that's helped like improve my grades and also like just improve professional development as well. And like you get to really experiment like who are you as like an employee as well. And really, like Jade said before, like just bridges that gap between uni and work, which can seem quite scary at first.
Just go for it. Like, honestly, hands down, this is the best thing I've ever done. Like Jade was saying, like it can be hard, but like when you look at the outcome, it's just a no-brainer, really. So I think any advice someone is if you're not sure, just give it a go, because at the end of the day, like, you're not sure, you're not guaranteed a place somewhere. So, and if you don't try, you never know. So just give it a go.
And I would just say go for it as well, because what do you have to lose, really, when you think about it? Go for it.
I'm the same. I just think it gets, you know, your foot in the door in a company, in a career that you want. So why not? Yeah, is the question.
Sorry to leave you to last, Isha.
That's okay. It's outside of the UCAS process. So if success is a target, then you want as many arrows as you can to hit the bullseye. And I think similar alongside, like, you can do like a UCAS application. Like I made a UCAS application. And then outside of that, I also had Network 75. And it's just about having like as many arrows, as many tools in your belt to get that job, because degrees, unfortunately, by themselves don't guarantee a job. And whilst you can do industry placements for a year, there's never like really an opportunity to have 5 years of industry experience with one company. And it just shows so much more about you and the types of skills that you can learn, and the company knows you better, and they can support you and see like where are your weaknesses, where are your strengths, and like how you can build on yourself, so that if you did decide to stay with a company or like go further than that and apply to other jobs, you've already got like a really good competitive edge over other students, even in things like grad schemes. So yeah, it's definitely worth a shot, I'd say.
I think I would tell my past self, it's all going to be online, so you best get ready. And just prepare to like work on it and teach yourself, because obviously in school it gets taught to you, and then we went into lockdown, so they had the struggle of that. But don't give up, because it's an easy thing to do, but just keep persistent, keep going, everything will click in the end and you will get there. So yeah, just don't give up, and everything's going to be online, so well, good luck.
Alice, I go to you next, because you're going further back in time.
It's just, it'll all be worth it in the end. It feels like a bit of a slog sometimes, but honestly, my 5 years of uni went so quick. Like, it's nuts. I think I started Network 75 about, I don't know, like 6 or 7 years ago now. And yeah, it just flies by. So just do it. And also, like, by the time you finish uni, like most people, if they do like a sandwich year, for example, with a placement, like a 1 year placement, you're only really like 1 year behind them. And I actually got a full-time job after my fourth year of uni. I decided to do my last year of uni in my spare time, and my company supported me doing that. So yeah, just do it.
Yeah, brilliant, well done. Jade, I haven't spoken to.
Yeah, like I said, it was a shock to the system when I first started, but I think probably what I would say is just not to be too hard on myself, because I just thought I didn't know anything, and you know, all these people are experienced, and that I felt like I wasn't adding any value. But I just think everything comes in time, and you'll learn from your experience. And especially for me, if I had done full time and left when obviously you're 21 and then joined, they expect you to know a lot and to have a lot of experience, and you wouldn't have. So I think this obviously, yeah, it does help, and yeah, just you can do it, get through it.
Brilliant. Did I ask you that, Isha? My
no.
Go on.
So one thing like I would say is like, don't fear rejection. I think a lot of people don't try because they're too afraid they're going to fail. And when I did my business interviews, like it took 3 or 4 interviews before I got a yes. So just keep persevering, and that's with anything, whether that's like your standard uni applications or apprenticeships outside of Network 75 as well. Like, just don't be afraid to get that no, because once you get that yes, all of those no's don't matter anymore. And also, like, no one's expecting you to be perfect on day one. It can be really overwhelming. Like, I didn't even know how to fold a letter on my first day working in the society, and we had to do all these letters, and there was actually like a certain way of doing it, and I had no idea. And like, that's okay. And like, now to think like I'm able to write emails, I can hold meetings, I can deliver on projects now, like compared to day one, looking back, I'm like, wow, there's been a big change. So yeah, no one expects perfection, but they do just want progress. And you should want that for yourself as well.
So like I said earlier, I actually managed to secure myself a full-time job after my fourth year in uni. So yeah, it was just my last year. And that was as a strategic planner within Network Rail. So I helped plan the long-term future of the railway, basically looking like 30, 40 years into the future, doing like business cases and cases for investment in infrastructure. And now I've just got a promotion. So I'm now a senior strategic planner within Network Rail, and I just love it. Like I said earlier, it's really good that you can kind of try a few different things within your host company before you kind of settle on a job. But as soon as I saw this job come up and I'd spent a bit of time with the team, I just knew like that's where I wanted to be. So yeah, so that's what I've done. Oh, and I'm doing a master's as well now. Maybe I'll never finish uni.
But yeah, I'm still yeah, so yeah, I know you mean. No, it's brilliant. Thanks very much.
Well, I love the course, not just because I'm obviously doing it, but I visited, I think, I can't remember which uni it was, but they went over obviously the module, and compared to USW, this one I just completely favoured more. And I think it was probably because they are recognised by three professional bodies, and I think it's the only one in the UK. So I, you know, thought that would be quite good as well. And I think probably my favourite thing is that now, so this is my third year that I'm doing this. I think if you were full-time, it would be your second year. That you get to do a 10-week internship. So obviously I just do mine with my company, but I think it's a good opportunity for me to do a project. This, I get the support of my lecturer and work, and I get to show what I've learned. So we're doing a communications campaign. But I get to really work with, you know, some other colleagues that are not in the UK as well, and just get, you know, to show everything that I've learned in uni and put it into practice. Whereas if I graduated and gone in to do that, I don't think I'd have the same confidence. And also we get the opportunity to do like additional, I don't want to say courses, but they are essentially, but one we're doing now is PR. So that would usually cost £2,000, and we get that for free because we're recognised by three bodies. So yeah, I love it. I think research, obviously all the other marketing degrees, but we do get a lot more opportunities and support with this. And Lauren, the module leader, she's amazing as well. So she'll really support you.
Well, brilliant. Thanks, Jade. What let's open it up then. What about the others in newer courses? So what do you particularly enjoy about you as Asia?
So I think one of the things I really enjoy is how general it is, because I'm someone who doesn't really know what career that I want to pursue. So being able to do it alongside work as well, like Alice said, just gives me a chance to really like go, okay, so I'm learning HR in uni, but what does that actually look like in a business environment? Or same with project management, like now that I've like actually done 2 years in that role, because I've asked to stay there, it's given me like a really good overall view of like what it's like to work in the department. And I think like when you only get to work somewhere for like a year, like you can kind of get like a romanticized view of it maybe, because you just don't get to see the full picture of what it's like to work there. So I really like that I get to see the reality compared to the theory, and sometimes that's different in a good way, and sometimes I can go back to my department and be like, oh, this is what we learned on project management. I think this would be like a really good methodology that we could use that we're not currently using. And they get to learn from us just as much as we learn from them. So I really like the partnership of being able to put theory into practice.
That's a really interesting point as well. You were adding something to the company that, you know, you were perhaps looking at things which are more cutting edge, where they did degrees 10, 15 years ago. Perhaps things have developed theory-wise within your industry, which they're not engaged with. So you've got a lot to add to the companies as well. And that's a really, really good point. Shamia?
Yeah, I would say with my course, I enjoy how kind of, like they said, general it is, because there's a few things. It's like management, because I'm doing finance and accounting, so there's management, accounting, financial accounting, then you're also doing data analysis, which kind of works with Excel and kind of financial software, and then you have actual personal finance where you're learning about mortgages, and it's like a range, because there's mortgages, pensions, insurance, interest rates, stuff like that, and then you've got how to actually do the other side of it, which is the accounting. It's just all mixed, really, so it kind of, you've got different directions, so you know which ones you kind of lean towards. So I like that it's a bit like a wide kind of variety, maybe not that wide, but it is. I do enjoy it. I'm still there learning on the path.
Alice?
Yes, I actually started mine doing general business management, and so for the first like 2 years you do general courses that all business students do, and then I actually decided to specialize in supply chain and logistics, just because I felt that fitted better with the company that I worked for, because I work Network Rail's the transport infrastructure company, so it just fitted better that I specialised in that one rather than something like HR or marketing. And it was just something that I enjoyed and yeah, I could apply to for work, and yeah, it's just fitted best.
There's so many different type of like activities do you have to do, because we have this kind of combined inbox and people send in, like queries through to help them out, and there's so many different things that you can help them out with. And I started enjoying it about 2 to 3 weeks in, because it was just something new, and picking up those things, being able to like help others as well as learning yourself, it feels great. I really enjoy it.
You still enjoying it, Alice, your workload?
Yeah, like I said earlier, it's definitely a balance. But what I like is the fact, so I absolutely love working for Network Rail and working for the railway, but I would never in a million years have thought of working for the railway. But because Network 75 sent out my CVs and said, well, this company wants to interview you, it was just good, because it kind of like throws you in the deep end, and I didn't really have any expectations when I joined. When I got accepted, and then when I joined, it was just nice to see something like new and interesting to me. And also like obviously it depends on your company, but there's like Network Rail is a massive company, like 40,000 people doing such a wide variety of things, so there's so many things I can get involved in. Obviously it depends on what company you go for, but I suppose that applies to any company really, how big or how small. But it was just good because it kind of threw me a bit out of my comfort zone, and I absolutely love it.
Well, good. Are you sure?
I think obviously like just like a traditional uni degree, as you go further and further into your education, there's going to be more things you're going to have to learn. It's going to get a bit more complex in terms of theory and like critical analysis, and obviously like the final peak of it is like a dissertation. So it does get harder with each year that you go, and it's the same thing with work as well. I've found that like I've been given a lot more responsibility like the longer I've stayed in my department. So when I started, like I was just doing like really small projects that I was doing like with support of other people, and then like as I kind of grew and got more and more like success with each project, like I kind of started delivering and leading my own. Like I started, like I digitized their broker online application process from start to finish, and that was a really exciting project to be a part of, and I feel like a lot of pride when I get to look at their website and see like, oh, I did that. And yeah, the workload can be hard sometimes, but I think it's important to have those conversations with your manager or with Network 75 or with your lecturers, like if it gets too much, and there's no shame in that, like everybody's human. So I've had to learn over time, it's like if I am struggling or if I am feeling a bit overwhelmed, I'm like, hey, I've got this assignment due, but then I've also got to do this like robotics training, or I've got to like deliver this project which has the same deadline day as like my assignment or something, then I've got to kind of like speak with my manager and be like, hey, like I'm feeling a bit overwhelmed at the moment, I need a bit more support, like remember that you're a student, and Network 75 really puts that in your mindset that like you're a student first before you're an employee. So make sure to look after yourself and your well-being as well with that workload. Don't feel like you have to go like, oh, I'm the youngest one, I'm inexperienced, so I should be taking everything on and I should never say no. Like, you're completely within your rights to say no, and they totally respect that as well, and they want you to have that conversation with them. And that's something that I've only really come into my own in my third year. So yeah, that's one piece of advice I would say. Like, if you are finding the workload heavy, don't be afraid to speak to them about it. They really want to support you and make it as easy of a journey as they can, as like you develop yourself through the next 5 years.
Brilliant. Jade?
Yeah, I think in terms of enjoying the industry, similar to Alice, I mean, because my role is in aviation, so passenger seats, I didn't even know this company existed, and they're 40 minutes away and they're, you know, global company. And I think, yeah, I got the opportunity for the interview and I thought, oh, I've never heard of them. And I wasn't really interested, you know, in aeroplanes. But I think when I got there and understood more, and the fact we make these really cool, you know, business and first class seats, and it is really, you know, interesting. And there wasn't actually an opening in the marketing department. So the marketing manager had left, and they weren't looking to advertise that post again. So I was quite lucky, really, in the fact that they decided to do it as an apprenticeship, and I got to be involved, and it's just really interesting. I love it. Usually, you know, we all just come in the morning, look at the emails, and then we'll have a team meeting. So we kind of do it as we look at the sales week ahead. So it's all of the sales team and marketing, and just looking at what actions we have to do that week. And then I just have a smaller catch up with my manager on what I need to focus on, what's going on with uni. We discuss what I've done on the Monday, Tuesday, and then I just, you know, go off to work on my own and any other things that are scheduled with other departments. And then I guess uni, obviously Monday and Tuesday, still online. They're a bit shorter this term. So we just have Monday learning and then Tuesday to work on the project. But yeah, I mean, like Aisha said, I dedicate those 2 days to study and to work on mainly university stuff, just so you don't get a clash. Obviously, I do some work in the evenings just because there's nothing else to do at the minute. But yeah, you know, is it completely just separate those days and just make them work together. Like I said, I discussed with my manager things as well. But yeah, I think that's it for me.
well said, Jade. Shamia?
Yeah, I agree. Like, in the morning, we have kind of weekly or monthly team calls because we have one team call, but then we have another kind of like the whole of finance kind of call. And we discuss what the profits were and have we reached our targets and what we are aiming for next time. So we have that kind of meeting, and then I have another meeting with my manager afterwards. Again, we talk about how uni went Monday and Tuesday, just kind of like melting into it. So like how our days went and how just it's not like hard full-on work. It is, they do care about you. They want to make sure you're okay and that you're handling everything okay. My manager again has said, if you need to take off time for uni, don't be afraid to just tell me, because we're here for you. So that's great. So I do that, and then obviously picking up what I have to do. And with uni, yeah, that's again Monday and Tuesday, and trying to dedicate my time to complete work I have in those days and separating them. So again, balance. But yes, it's good.
Aisha?
Yeah, so similar to the guys, really, we have usually like a daily meeting, especially being online. Like, communication is key, and it's kind of hard to do that when you're working on projects. And it's a bit like, there can be like a lot of different things that you're working on in a day. So you have to really choose like what you want to prioritize. Like, you've got to look at the deadlines and like, is there any obstacles that you're facing that could have like a detriment on the projects that you're working on? Like, what support do you need? And also just like usually like arranging or like leading meetings with like other departments, because we're usually working in collaboration with them to be able to improve their processes. So yeah, my days can be really varied. Either sometimes they're just full of meetings, or like I'm doing a lot of like work on my own, like just trying to get my sides of the projects done, or like I'm having like meetings with my manager and my team to talk about like how we can move forward in terms of like the projects that we're looking in our portfolio. So yeah, that's definitely one of the things that I enjoy. Like every day is different for me. So yeah, you never know what you're going to expect, but it's always good.
Brilliant. Alice?
Yeah, I echo what the girls have said, really. I think it's really important to make sure that you try and do your uni work on your uni day. So a lot of my lectures, especially the first like 4 years, often I'd have a lecture in the morning and then a lecture like late afternoon. So I would spend like most of my time in the library with the other two girls and three girls actually, that were doing Network 75. So we actually use that time to do our uni work. Well, A, it was fresh in our heads, and B, it means that even though you do still have to do some uni work on the weekends or in the evenings, if you've done a bulk of it then, you have some time to yourself, because it's really important to take time to yourself. But also for work, I would have a weekly call with a mentor in work. And she would just like make sure I was okay, like ask what I've got going on in work, ask what I've got going on in uni, because I think, like, especially when I first started, they hadn't had anyone in Network 75, and I was the youngest person in the office, like, by a mile. So I think you sometimes get, like, peaks and troughs of workload. But also remember not to say yes to everything. Like, I was quite bad at doing that, because you just want, like, all the experience and to try different things. But you've got to remember, like, you do have uni work to do as well, and you don't work there full time. Well, so in the holidays you work full time. So I would like sit down with my managers like just before the holidays to make sure I had enough work to do over that longer period, that because I was in 5 days a week then. But well, most of the time I definitely always have something to do, and if not, it's about being proactive and finding something to do as well.
It's great. Yeah, something interesting you said there, Alice, is it's not a question I got, it's just something I'm interested in myself. How did you find the experience of being a student? You obviously had two or three friends who were doing Network 75 on the same course as you. So it's different to being a student full time, but you still had an experience of having friends in university as well.
So at the start, there were me and three other girls who were on Network 75, and we met each other on the first day, and ever since then we've kind of been inseparable. One of the girls, she chose to specialise in HR, with the three of us specialised in supply chain logistics. So we weren't always in uni then on the same days, like after the second year. But it's just really important just to reach out, because they just know exactly exactly what you're going through. I think often full-time students don't understand, and they might not understand. You're getting pressure in work sometimes, you're getting pressure in uni, and they can do whatever they want. They can come in at like 2 o'clock in the morning, whereas we've got to be up for work like 6:30 the next day. So like, and like all my friends from home, they all just did just went to uni like most people did, and it was quite hard for them to understand as well. So yeah, if you have other people with you on Network 75, it definitely makes a huge difference.
Alicia, what about you?
Yeah, I agree. Like in the first year, I feel like all the Network 75 students like really band together in a sense of camaraderie, because like Alice said, you're all in the same boat. You're all talking to each other about like, oh my God, it was my first day of work yesterday. What did you guys do? Did you have the induction? What department are you in? And stuff like that. And it's really, really great. I really, really enjoy like hearing other people's experiences, and it's been great to hear the girls' experiences as well of like what it's like to work in their company, and every company is really different. So I guess like a tip from me would be to like look at the placement list on Network 75 and really have a look at those companies, because sometimes like Jade said, like I got like interviews for companies I'd never even heard about, and you really don't know like what opportunities lie out there. Like, I didn't think if I went into Monmouthshire Building Society, which is typically like a financial services sector, to be given the opportunity to work on like AI and financial technology. So you really don't know what you're going to get, and I'd say don't underestimate like a small company, because they can give you loads of opportunities too. It's not just the bigger companies. So yeah, just see like where you'd fit in. Would you prefer to work in a smaller company, or do you prefer like a large company? Like, just find what works for you. But yeah, like in terms of like Network 75 and just having that camaraderie is really nice. And yeah, you have people like who understand, like you're not on your own, you know. Like sometimes it can be hard if like other people in your family might not be doing like an apprenticeship. Like I was the first one, so to be able to have other people on my course who were going through a similar journey, it was really nice.
Thanks, Lisa. Jade?
Yeah, I think like Aisha said, you know, you all go through the same thing, and because it's a unique course, it is nice to have that bunch that you talk to at, you know, the 2 days that you're in. And I mean, a few of us specialised in marketing, so there's 5 of us, and you know, we all have a group chat and we all speak every day, you know, whether it is just, you know, normal friendly chat or about work. And I mean, we're really like close bunch, so don't think that just because you join the scheme you might miss out on the sort of, you know, uni life then, because I've made some really great friends.
This is difficult one for you, Shamia, because obviously your experience is completely different to the other three. How do you find it?
I think, well, when I joined Network 75, I didn't actually realise that there were more people that did Network 75. I don't know why I didn't consider it. I didn't know. So when I found out that there was someone that was also a part of Network 75 in the same company that I was doing, I was so like, I was just so glad that I wasn't on my own and that there was other people that did the same thing as me. And then I was like, there's more people that do Network 75. So I ended up making a group chat for us all on WhatsApp, and then finding out what they do, and what it was just great because everyone was just like, oh, we're not on our own. We actually, there's more of us, you know, and like we can all speak to each other. And we have like another chat where everyone in the whole course is in, and then you've got your Network 75 chat. It's really nice to know that there's people that you can talk to about your work, and then again about other stuff. So I was just glad to be in those group chats and know the people, because it's hard online.
I just chose to stay because I really liked it, but say if I didn't like it at the end, I could just go somewhere else. Like, you're not, once you've done your 5 years, you're allowed to look elsewhere. And it's like, if you like the company, great, stay. But also, obviously, depends on the market situation at the time, especially now with COVID going on. It just gives you a lot more opportunity. So if you did want to apply somewhere else, you've got that experience. Yeah, definitely. Well, obviously, again, it depends like what company you work for. But yeah, there's so many like development opportunities, and like I'm doing a master's, for example. That's another development opportunity you can look at. And there's lots of different things you could do after. So you're not always just done after your degree.
The university is more of a, like an informal interview chat, so just working with you to sort of shape your application then, so you know, just asking you know your grades, what your predicted grades are, what courses you're interested in learning, so you can pick a top three so that your applications get sent out to other placements then that are not specific to your first one then. So that one was really I don't want to say easy, but you know, easy going, as in don't feel too nervous about that. We'll obviously be prepared, but it is more to understand what you are like as a person and your goals. But for the company side, obviously they did give me a lot of support as well as with everyone, just sort of like tips to prepare. Obviously it is a bit more formal. You would probably dress a bit smarter and do some research on the company and things. And obviously, like I said, I had to create a poster for mine, but it's a lot more, you know, riding on that second interview than the first one, because once you know you've got a place, you just want to secure that placement then in the second round.
Brilliant, thanks Jade. Shamira?
I would pretty much agree with everything that's just been said.
Yeah.
I don't know if your guys' interviews was online, but for me, it was, so with Network 75, that was a video interview and that was an informal one. And it was my first time having an interview, I didn't know what to expect, so obviously I was nervous. And I just had my phone on the side and I was like, okay, I'll be fine. And then answering them, I prepared beforehand, like why I wanted to be a part of it. I knew what I was going to say. And that was obviously different to the work one. You had to dress a bit formal and I kind of panicked. I didn't even think I had any formal clothes. But yeah, I did some research about that company beforehand, but it's not as hard as you think it's going to be. So like, try not to stress when you go into the interviews, like, calm down and it's okay, like don't panic, because I was stressing too much. And I remember with my career wheels advisor, he said you can take a notebook, and I did this in my company, like the Arcadis interview. I actually, because I forget really quickly, so I wrote down the question and I was like, sorry, can I just write this down a minute? And they're like, yeah, of course. So I just did a keyword of what I was just asked, and it's like, it's okay to just be like, can I write this down for a moment? And then once you've got it there, you can pick yourself back up and then just explain. So try not to panic, you'll be all right, pretty much.
Well done, well said. Anything to add, Aisha?
I think just around the business interviews, I think like they are different to the uni ones in terms of like, they really want to get your skills or like how like employable you are. And what I found is like, they're not necessarily looking at your academics, but they're looking at like, what volunteering have you done? Like, what situations can you say that like you worked as part of a team or you led a team? Or I was asked like, what have you worked on recently that didn't go well? Why? What would you do in hindsight that would be better? So like, yeah, just kind of like search up some typical questions that they would ask around like your competency and like try and look at the type of skills that you might have said in your application. Read your application because they will reference it to you. So yeah, just be prepped with that and like have like different examples of like where you've used like common skills like team working, leading, communication, because they will ask on that. Because like, although like you won't, they're not expecting you to know everything about the job, but they just want to know that you have a basic level of skill and enthusiasm to want to work there and just show that like you're willing to learn and like make sure that you prep a question afterwards. Like one question that I asked was what's the culture like at the company, and they really liked that question and they thought, wow, you know, she really wants to understand how their team dynamic works, because they also want to see like whether your personality will fit in to theirs. And also it's a two-way street, so just like they're trying to figure out if you're the right fit for them, try to figure out if they're the right fit for you, because not every company is going to suit you. There might be companies that like, similar to like how you have like a personality, they might be more bubbly and outgoing, or they might be more serious, and like it just depends on like what environment do you think. Like, look around, like if you do get a chance to go to the company, look around and see how people are acting. What are they wearing? What's the type of dress code that they have? Like, do their business values align with yours? Like, that's really important, because you're going to be there for 5 years, you know, so just see, like, it's a chance for you to see if they're the right fit for you as well.
Well said. Alice?
Obviously my Network 75 interview was quite a while ago now. And I remember, actually, I dressed quite formally. I remember I went in a white shirt. But yeah, they just, that interview is kind of to almost like figure you out, to figure out whether you are suitable for the scheme, because not everyone is suitable for the scheme, because it is hard and it does take dedication. And then for my interviews for my company, the companies that I interviewed for Network Rail, I did have to provide a presentation. So some companies might ask for that, so be prepared, and practice in front of a mirror, to your family, to your friends. And I just want to say, like, just try and get your personality across. You're not just you're not just someone going for a job. Show them who you are and show them how you could fit into a company and what you think you'd be good at, because if you're boring, they won't want you. So just just show your personality and be like really enthusiastic and tell them why you want the job, why you'd like to work there. Show that you've done your research on that company. Show them why, what they're about.
Just go for it. You know, like we've all said, it is such a good opportunity, and it probably will be the best thing you do in terms of your career. So just apply.
Brilliant. Shamia?
Yeah, I say don't hesitate. If you've even got the slight interest in it, go for it. Don't hold back. Just do it.
Brilliant. Aisha?
Apprenticeships aren't really like tea and coffee jobs anymore. You can gain some really valuable skills. And after the 5 years, when you graduate and you realize you don't have any debt, you have 5 years that you can put on your CV. You have a competitive edge over everyone else who's just graduated. You'll realize how like valuable it was and like, wow, that really was worth it. So yeah, don't be afraid of the time scale. I mean, like I started when I was 20, so I'm going to be 25 when I graduate, but I'm 25 with 5 years of experience behind me. So yeah, I wouldn't worry about that.
I wish I was 25.
Well, I was actually 25 the other day. Honestly, like in hindsight, because obviously I've graduated a couple of years ago now, it was the best thing I've ever done. It set me up for my career for life. I've got no debt. And I just learned so much on the scheme, like, and you don't necessarily get that opportunity to just go for a job after, or even a graduate scheme, because the graduate scheme usually something like a year long and you get to see bits, whereas this 5 years, you see a lot happens in 5 years. So yeah, honestly, just go for it. Best thing I've ever done.